Don't think of it like you need to constantly be doing Facebook lives and like that stuff will suck the life out of you.
Yeah, great points, man. This kind of leads into the next question that I saw Leah McRae posted. She asks, do you have any tips of how we get out of the clutter at the moment? I understand value of the content, but I have heard so many people saying how exhausted they are by everyone trying to flood the market with everything. It's like they have content hangovers during this time. Dude, I can relate. I can seriously relate. Like feeling like you're always on social media, coming up with the next post you got to put up, the next video you need to do. I'm seeing so many people nodding right now. What about you, bro? What's your game plan with that?
Yeah, so like you're like, when we first spoke, like you were like, dude, like you're a content marketing machine. How do you get out all that stuff, right? I spend 1 hour a week on content. 1 hour, that's it, right? So I've got a full-time videographer that obviously does a lot of the editing, but it's like, man, I'm busy running my business, dude. Like my content is documenting my life and documenting the climb. And all I'm doing is teaching people the things that I'm doing every single day, right? So for me, the thing that works the most is having dedicated times where I'm scheduling to do that stuff. So it might be like, okay, I'm gonna shoot 1 hour a week with my video guy. I'm gonna get him to go through YouTube comments and start to see what people want, right? And then I'm gonna spend another half an hour a week just thinking about how can I help my market? What is it that they want? How can I get my prospect the results that they want, whether or not they ever give me a dollar? How can I help that person, right? So don't think of it like you need to constantly be doing Facebook lives and like that stuff will suck the life out of you, right? If you're constantly on social media doing that stuff, and if you're consuming and you're not just a producer, I consume very, very little on these platforms, right? I'm in and I'm out, right? I'm providing value and I'm bouncing. I'm not in there looking at everyone else's contents and any of that kind of stuff. Like I'm there to basically do my piece and bounce. But it's like death by a thousand cuts, and you're constantly checking into social media and seeing all the comments on all your stuff and doing all that stuff, then it is going to be a drain and you're going to be like, man, this thing is annoying, right? But if you're like, okay, this is the dedicated time that I spend on social, and then I'm out, I'm actually doing the main thing. Social media is not the main thing, right? The main thing is really becoming a master at your craft and being the best person in your industry and being able to provide more value than any other person in your market. And it's not the other way around. And people have, it's all flipped, right? Because like you have to get attention, but you have to have something worthy that once you get that attention, that you can flip it and turn it into money. And the only way that you're going to be able to do that is if you know your topic cold. You know every single nuance of everything that you need to know. And that's what you want to be focused on. So when you do put out content, it strikes like lightning, because people can just tell, like this girl or this guy is legit. They know their stuff. So focus most of your time on that, right? Like I'm sure anyone that's watched the Last Dance documentary series on the Bulls and Michael Jordan recently, like just look at Jordan, like look at all the stuff and everything that he got from all the deals with Nike, all the endorsements, the movies. Why did he get those things? Because he was the best, right? He was the best to ever do it. And he focused on his craft. He let the pain of failure sting so deep that he was never going to go to those places again. And he just focused, right? In the off season, he done the weights. He did everything that he needed to do to become a master. And that's really what you want to focus on, is how can you be the Michael Jordan of your space?
Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure that you click the like button and subscribe. We're dropping a video on YouTube every other day. And if you've got any questions about any of the content that I covered in this video, just basically leave a comment with hashtag HeySubri in the comment section. And every week we're also trying to go through all those questions and get them answered. So go ahead, click subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.